So in the previous class we have discussed about the defects in the crystals, that is different crystals like stoichiometric crystal, non-stoichiometric crystals. Like these crystals we have studied the defects. Okay, so today in this class let's discuss about the density of the unit cell. As you already know the unit cell, so there are many types. So today class let's discuss about the density of that unit cell. Okay, right. So now, as you already know the formula of the density, so that is density is equal to mass divided by volume. You already know this one, but we are finding what? Density of the unit cell. So the same thing. So here density of the unit cell is equal to what? The same thing, mass of the unit cell. Divided by volume of the unit cell. Volume of the unit cell. By knowing the mass of the unit cell and the volume of the unit cell, we can easily find out the density of the unit cell. Okay, so let's start here. What is the mass of the unit cell? That is the mass of the unit cell is equal to number of atoms present in the unit cell, present in unit cell, into mass of each atom. Means there are different atoms are present here. The mass of the each atom into how many number of atoms are present here. By that we can easily calculate the mass of the unit cell, right? So now the number of atoms, it is indicated by the symbol Z. What about the mass of each atom? As you already know, the mass of each atom or the mass of atom is nothing but the atomic mass divided by Avogadro's number or Avogadro's number, right? So it can be written as Z atomic mass. We can write it as what? M divided by into Avogadro's number. It can be indicated by the symbol Na. So this is what the mass of the unit cell. If you want to find out the mass of the unit cell, so this is Z into M divided by Ma or Na. So that is Avogadro's number. What about the volume of the unit cell? You already studied. The volume of the unit cell is nothing but the A cube or the cube of the edge length. So here the volume of the unit cell is equal to A. So just substitute here. So hence the density of unit cell D is equal to the mass of the unit cell. So that is Z into M divided by Na. Z into M divided by Na whole divided by volume of the unit cell. That is nothing but A cube. So it can be written as D is equal to Z into M divided by AQ into ENA. So this is what the important formula or expression to find out the density of the unit cell. You know, different unit cell, right? So D means what? Here D is density of unit cell. What about Z? Number of atoms. So this number of atoms is different for the different unit cell. For example, the number of atoms for simple cube. So the one atom is present in the simple cube. So here it is, number of atom will be one. What about the BCC, body centered cubic unit cell? The number of atoms present in the BCC is 2. What about the FCC? face centered cubic unit cell. The number of atoms which are present in the face centered cubic unit cell, it will be 4. So this will be fixed for the each unit cell, right? The number of atoms or number of constituent particles are present here, it is respectively that unit cell. Next, come to the m. M is nothing but atomic mass or the mass of the formula, or formula mass, or atomic mass or formula mass, right? Next, a cube is the volume of the unit cell. Next, na, so write it as capital or small. Na, so na is nothing but what? Avogadro's number. You already know Avogadro's number is nothing but 6.022 into 10 to the power 23. So this is what Avogadro's number. By knowing this, you can easily find out the unit density of the units. Okay, let's discuss some more problems based on this one. So you may get one or two problems based on this density in your annual examination. Okay, let's discuss some numerical problem based on this density. Okay. Come to the numerical problem which is given your NCERT textbook. So that is, niobium crystallizes in a body centered cubic structure, means they are given the BCC unit cell, if density is 8.55 gram per cm cube, calculate the atomic radius of niobium given its atomic mass, that is 93 mu. Okay, so they are given some data here. We have to find out what? Calculate the atomic radius of the niobium, right? We have to find out the radius, not even a edge length. Okay, first write down the what are the given data. So let's start, write the solution. First, what are the given things? Niobium crystallizes in the body centered cubic structure. Body centered means what? It is a BCC. So hence the number of atoms is what? 2, because BCC is having the number of particles is present is 2. Hence they are given the Z. So Z is equal to what? 2, because it is a BCC, body centered cubic unit cell. Next, what they are given? The density of that crystal is given. It is 8.55 gram per cm cube. It is minus. So that is density is equal to 8.55 gram per cm cube. Next, what they told you to calculate? Radius r. R is equal to how much? So you have to calculate this one. You already know the formula. So that is, density is equal to Z into M divided by A cube into Avogadro's number. So let's substitute the values here. You already know that Z is 2 here. M, the mass of the unit cell, it is given, that is 93. Write down that one. Mass of atom, it will be 93. Mu. So that is also given term. So M substitute here. A cube, I don't know the A cube, that I have to find out here. By knowing the edge length, that is A, I can easily find out the radius of the niobium. So that I have to find out this A cube. A, it is a Avogadro's number, it is given 6.02, that is Na is equal to 6.02 into 10 to the power 23. So substitute here. Now this will become density. So density is given 8.55 gram per cm cube. So here Z, so Z will be 2 here. Next, mass is given, that is 93 grams. Next, so A cube, I have to find out this one, into Na, Avogadro's number, that is 6.022 r into 10 to the power 23. So now simplify this one, that is, so write down, I'll send this A cube here and this one here. So that is, ए क्यूब इज इक्वल टू 2 इंटू 93 डिवाइडेड बाय, सो दिस इज 8.55 इंटू 6.022 इंटू 10 टू द पावर 23. सो सिंप्लीफाई दिस वन एंड टेल मी द आंसर. Okay, so what is the answer? So here you will get, after simplify this one, you will get around 36.12 into 10 to the power minus 24. So this is the edge length and it is CMQ. Okay, so what about the A? A is equal to, so this one under the square root of 36.12 into 10 to the power minus 24. So if I remove this a cube, mean or write as it is a cube, I'll take the cube root here, hence here also I should take the cube root. So now here a is equal to what? 36.12 into 10 to the power minus 24. So this is the cube, right? So take the cube and tell me the answer. After simplifying, you will get the A is equal to 3.306 into 10 to the power minus 10. So this is what the edge length. But I have to find out what? Radius here. So they are asked for calculate the atomic radius. As you already know, so this is the BCC, body centered cubic in itself. You know the relation. So that is, A is equal to 4 by root 3 R. So this is what the relation between edge length and the radius. Now I have to calculate the radius. Hence R is equal to root 3 into A divided by 4. Substitute the value, root 3 into, what is the A value? That is 3.306 into 10 to the power minus 10 divided by 4. Calculate and tell me the answer. Okay, after simplifying this one, you will get, yes, it is 1.431 into 10 to the power minus 10 meter. Okay, so here is also meter. Here it is 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter, but here it is 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So here, this is what? The radius of the niobium. So we found out the radius of the niobium by using the density